My name is Ms. Austin, and I'm one of the 8th grade teachers at Pleasant Tech Academy. And to my left is Ms. Gupton, my colleague as well, a young 8th grade teacher. We will have our welcoming by Christina Rosario.
Frazier, Mrs. Jubilee, Mr. McCormick, Ms. Young, and I can't see it. I think also, if I missed anyone, please forgive me. Also, I'd like to recognize the staff at Pleasant Tech. Thank you so much for coming. I'd like to just say to the parents, this is the time that your children are going to really, really need you. They're going to need you to push them and support them and to let them know that there's nothing they can do. If they reach for the stars, they'll never come up with a handful of dirt. Thank you. We can still do it.
seeds of knowledge have planted in our brains, and the fear that we have of the unknown does not mean a lack of courage, but teaches us to be cautious and sure-footed. Although we will no longer be together as a group, the minds that we made will forever be a part of us. We have to enjoy these years of our youth, make the most of our opportunities given to us from our parents and teachers, because the only way we will pass this way again is for our fond memories. As we say our goodbyes as a group, take with you the positive things we have learned from our teachers and parents. Some of you I will see over summer, at the mall, or talk to you on the phone. But always remember to encourage each other and to be and do everything positive. We will make our parents very proud of us and all our accomplishments, because very soon we're going to want to use the car.
And I hope my students will give me their all as well. Also, I Thank you for coming again from NYC.
give them all the love and to show them how much we love them by putting the flowers on their casket. We don't like to do it that way, so we'd like to give you your flowers now.
Whatever they put their mind to. So I'm going to introduce such a man. knowledgeable of who he is or who we are as a people, who is competent, who has the skill to do whatever he puts his mind to, and is confident or believes he can do what he put his mind to. Here then is our guest speaker, a noted author, a renowned speaker, and a loving parent. I bring forth Dr. Franklin Smith.
Thank you so much. Can you hear me without this, or should I use this mic?
Well, I've got, you've got to just harness
superior being don't drop nothing on you that you ain't been told about. Ye who will hear, please hear. You got 2 months, 60 days, whatever your weakness is, that high school will take it off. Who horny in here? I've been blessed. a trick bag. I'm gonna give you a test. You should have the test in 2 months, 3 months, maybe October. It's the biggest test you're gonna take. It's the, is it the PSAT? The biggest test you're gonna take in your life. It will determine how your great-grandchildren eat. Intend me. It will determine how your great-grandchildren eat. SAT. Now, how you gonna compete on the SAT if you turn it on BET? Are you living with MTV? How you gonna compete? How you gonna compete if you Venezuela Latina and you lost in J-Lo? Or you Latina and you lost just like I do? Who is he? Tell me. Can you do Latin?
A dream isn't handed to you. You
they're going to hate you. But you're not there to be loved. You're there to be a parent. You have to, I say this, you have to enforce your will. You listening to me, parents? You're almost there. You've got to will the next few years by the force of your persistence. Listen to me. I can't advocate violence. I don't advocate violence. But I do advocate shame. And by any means necessary to get these children, young adults, to do what they shall do and are meant to do. Am I making myself clear? I don't care if you got to live at the school. You live there. I don't care if they say they between 16 and 21, the wars between mama and their mama and daughter is out of the outer world. I watch my own daughter. She gonna throw down on my friend, my wife. She gonna, 16 years old, she gonna throw down. I told her, if you do, I'm gonna beat you like a man.
That's right.
And the piece of furniture I broke because I was so mad is still in the house as a reminder. It's an altar because it will be my way or out. Because I'm not going to look back at these years and say I have stepped. I can say to my maker, God, I did everything possible. I sacrificed everything for my kids. Once I can do that, I can go to my peace. But I did everything. I heard my mama say, if I were to listen to the call of the men, you wouldn't be where you are. If I were to listen to the call of the clothing store, you wouldn't be where you are. If I had listened to the call of liquor or any other kind of drug, you won't be where you are. The only call I listened to was your need and my dream for you. That's parenting. And she told me later on, you know, when I think of you and I think of what you do, I get young again. When you do for your parents, they get young again. They want that picture of you. They want that picture of you at their workplace. And when they sit down for coffee with other people, they want to reach in the bag and say, this is my son, and he's doing this. This is my daughter, and they're doing this. And it takes years away. Did anybody hear me? Are you too young? Are you too young?
No.
Did you hear?
Yes.
Would you swear to do it?
Yes.
Would you swear to do it?
Yes.
Would you swear by the Almighty to do it?
Yes.
They said yes, that they will. Please give them a hand.
Let's give Professor Smith another round of applause. And now we will have our presentation of awards from Councilman Harmon. Mayor Peterson was unable to attend, but he sent Mr. Harmon in his place.
Being a retired principal, I was going to give these young people a word of advice, just one. But my now friend, Dr. Smith, I thank you, covered the territory. So I'll just leave that alone. This evening, I must say I'm very honored and pleased to be here. I was at the school number of other times, but one to be part of a program, and I really enjoyed that experience. I hope they will invite me back again, as long as it is not mayor. 2 years ago, Mayor Peterson came up with the idea to create the Mayor Peterson Education Foundation. And for some reason, he selected me to be the chairperson. And I want to say to you, I'm very pleased to be here as City Council President and the chairperson of this foundation to present these two awards. I would like to just be a part of our mission statement. The Ralph Peterson Education Foundation is a nonprofit organization whose mission is to give encouragement to every youth and graduating seniors to stay in school and attend their education and social development. Now, the reason I call your attention to the two awards that I'm going to give tonight, monitor their clock at lunch. But the two awards, or the four awards that we give to graduating seniors, is really, they range from $500 to $1,000. And Mayor Peterson, at the present time, was able to get, year before last, a $1,000 scholarship. Of course, the student had to write an essay or whatever. And last year, he got $2,000. And where he is this year, he's trying to get $3,000 for next year. So we can pass on to students of Pleasantville. So at this time, I would like to make the presentation. First one I would like to, this is for social improvement. The student is Robert Laws. Two awards. While Mayor Peterson's away, I've been
going to give a big speech. We privately have our little talk in the back. I'm not supposed to get emotional because I'm stern and I won't. So at this time, I'd like to start with Brittany Banks. Alexander.
one of my babies, Miss Charmaine Blocker. Alexandra Ramirez.
as a lover and death, Ms. Juana Socorro Aguirre. It's not easy putting on a commencement ceremony. We needed the help of so many people. We asked quite a few. We got many. The next person, all the balloons, she was there for me for everything. If I asked her to do something, she did it. No hesitation asked. She was in the middle of a class. I asked her to print out something. She did it. Right now, she's probably somewhere cutting cake, helping out. Ms. Zeta Rosado.
Thank you.
closing remarks?
Thank you.
concludes our graduation. Please give a round of applause to the class of 2002 Clemson Academy.